Hi, I'm Ron Hazelton, and this is a video with a message I care about very much, residential fire safety. I know you care about it too. Whether you're a building official or community planner, in a rural town or a large city, residential fires are a problem. A home fire is a tragedy that can happen to anyone, any day, at any time, without warning. Each year in the U.S., these fires take some 3,000 lives and billions of dollars in personal property literally go up in smoke. In fact, home fires cause more than $6 billion in direct property damage each year. You may work closely with developers or builders, but ultimately, your job is to protect homeowners and occupants. You play a vital role in helping to ensure their safety. I hope you'll take a few moments with me now to learn about home fire sprinkler systems and the standard for installing these systems in one and two family homes, NFPA 13D. I'd like to clear up some of the confusion and tell you how home fire sprinkler systems are helping jurisdictions and communities like yours. Fire sprinklers have protected commercial buildings for more than 100 years. Seeing the life safety advantages of sprinklers, building codes changed to include hotels, high-rise, and multifamily buildings. Basically, anywhere we sleep, where we are most vulnerable to fire. Today, there is a growing trend as thousands of one- and two-family homes are being built each year, protected with automatic home fire sprinkler systems. Let's start with some simple facts. The majority of home fire deaths occur at night when we're sleeping. A fire can reach deadly proportions in a home in fewer than 3 minutes, so every second counts.
People think they have a lot more time to get out of a burning building than they actually do. And in fact, because of things in our homes, the amount of time you have to get to safety has been shrinking over the years. We now know that a fire can go from first ignition to flashover in just 3 minutes. That's no time at all. That's why sprinklers offer such peace of mind, because as you're getting your family to safety, that sprinkler, often just one, is controlling the fire, even putting it out.
Smoke alarms are essential and have been in building codes for years because they warn people, where there's smoke, there's fire. If people respond immediately and properly, it could save their lives. But what if they don't or can't? People at highest risk of dying in a fire are young children and older adults who die because they don't respond quickly or aren't able to escape on their own.
We're finding out that little children often sleep right through the conventional smoke alarm, and that older people often have trouble hearing the alarm, so it may not offer them protection either. That's why sprinklers add such an additional layer of safety and benefit to people.
Fire sprinklers actually control the fire, suppress it, and usually extinguish it before firefighters even arrive on the scene. Each sprinkler is individually activated by the high heat from flames. Now, typically, only one sprinkler closest to the fire will activate. The sprinkler will control or put out the flames and prevent the spread of deadly smoke and gases. And because sprinklers cool the smoke and gases produced by the fire, they prevent what firefighters call flashover, where the smoke and gases in a room reach a critical temperature and become explosive, engulfing the entire room in flames. Fire sprinklers save lives and they limit property damage. Because they respond quickly and automatically, they often confine damage to just one room. And the water flow from sprinklers is only a fraction compared with the high-powered water hoses used by firefighters.
The fire department comes in, they're going to put 140, 150 gallons a minute onto that fire. You're going to wind up with a lot of water damage. And with the sprinkler system, the heads automatically come on only where the heat source is. That is the only head in the whole house that will go off.
Now, here's something you may not have thought about. Fire sprinklers also protect the lives of firefighters when they report to a fire scene. If there is an uncontrolled fire burning and a chance that someone is in the building, firefighters will risk their own lives to save the lives of others. Why put your firefighters in harm's way? Now let me ask you a question. Do you think newer homes are safer than old homes? Well, data shows that occupants cause most residential fires.
We can build homes and buildings that are going to last for hundreds of years. The problem comes when we start putting people inside those buildings. Most of the fires that we see are caused by the activities that the people are doing inside their home.
Today's larger homes with open designs allow a fire to grow quickly and spread throughout the house. The expanded use of synthetic material along with other modern contents and furnishings provide a powerful fuel source.
Home environment typically now includes many products that we did not have 30, 40 years ago. Multiple television sets, computers, other types of products which are made of these synthetic materials. So the overall fuel load has increased not only in terms of the materials used, but the bulk of the materials as well.
Advances in technology have helped to make home fire sprinklers affordable in new home construction. Now, you may be familiar with this booklet. It's the installation standard for fire sprinkler systems in 1 and 2 family dwellings, the National Fire Protection Association standard, NFPA 13D. The primary purpose is to save lives, and the goal is to provide 10 minutes of sprinkler flow to allow occupants time to escape and the fire department to respond. In 1 and 2 family dwellings, NFPA 13D only requires sprinklers in occupied space. Sprinklers are not required in smaller bathrooms or closets, garages, attached to open structures like carports or porches or attics. Now, this helps keep the systems affordable. Statistics show that fires rarely start in these areas, and so the standard takes cost and practicality into consideration by not requiring installation there. In today's building code, garages are usually separated from living quarters by some non-combustible materials. Concerned about leakage? Well, NFPA 13D also ensures that fire sprinkler systems are reliable and watertight. In fact, fire sprinklers and the piping are subject to rigorous testing and certification requirements that make them as reliable as any other system in the home.
We've been certifying residential sprinklers for actually over 20 years. Just for the sprinklers themselves, there's over 30 different tests that are applied to determine whether or not they are going to perform as intended out in the field.
As for design and installation, NFPA 13D recognizes two different approaches, standalone and multi-purpose. A standalone system is a dedicated sprinkler system that doesn't share piping with domestic plumbing fixtures. Multi-purpose systems, on the other hand, have piping that serves both sprinklers and domestic plumbing fixtures. Each approach has unique advantages, which you can learn more about by reviewing NFPA 13D. With respect to piping materials, plastic and copper piping are the most commonly used. The two types of plastic pipe that are permitted are chlorinated polyvinyl chloride, or CPVC, and cross-linked polyethylene, or PEX. Plastic pipe is really simplified installation and made sprinkler systems cost-effective and quick to install. In areas where freezing is a concern, NFPA 13D provides guidance for proper insulation and freeze protection, just like you would do on other water piping in the home. A common approach is the use of wall-mounted sprinklers in areas beneath an unfinished attic to avoid installing pipe in the attic itself. As with any other part of a residential plumbing system, the key is to require quality installation by a contractor who knows residential sprinklers. When a good contractor is used, sprinkler pipes pose no more threat of leaks or freezing than any other component of the domestic plumbing system. Speaking of water, let's take a look at a typical system. With the municipal water supply, the 10-minute duration required by NFPA 13D won't be an issue, since the water supply is always available and will not run out. Now, when well water is used as the source, a tank and pump may be needed to supply pressure. In general, fire sprinkler systems require very little maintenance. The sprinklers themselves require none at all. The system should be tested every year by the homeowner or the sprinkler contractor to make sure the flow switch and alarms remain operable. Increasingly, community planners, water department, and fire and building officials are realizing the benefits of sprinklered homes to their communities. Communities that require residential fire sprinklers are recognizing not only life safety, but infrastructure benefits. These systems are an affordable, readily available, and proven technology that protect property and prevent the loss of life if fire strikes.
And from our standpoint, from the water department, a fire hydrant can be a fairly costly expenditure in terms of appurtenance maintenance. We have the capital to install it, and then it's in there for the life of the system. You have to continuously maintain that hydrant, whereas the fire sprinkler systems, you put them in, and pretty much you can forget about it. So from the standpoint of the city, it was a win situation. From the standpoint of the building community, they got to pay less because there was less fire hydrants being installed.
We have had no problems with any of our sprinklers. And it's definitely a selling feature whenever we go to sell homes, especially for a safety feature. And that's one of the things that we definitely promote in our marketing of our development. The cost is just not what people imagine it to be. The trouble that you think dealing with other subcontractors, they all work well together, and we've had very little issues. And the issues we've had, we've been able to work through.
Community should really look at this and look at the true facts and not just rely on the misconceptions and the misinformation that's out there. I don't think there's anything the community could do that would benefit them more than protect their community and protect their firefighters through the use of automatic sprinkler protection.
Now, you may be concerned about what impact sprinklers will have on builders in your community. As more homes are being protected with fire sprinklers, builders readily learn to incorporate sprinklers into the new home construction process. Fire sprinklers can be roughed in anytime after the plumbing and HVAC installation and trimmed at the same time other contractors are working.
It really doesn't impact me in terms of timing, whether he's there ahead of the electrician. So like most folks, I guess, we run the HVAC, then the plumber, then the electrician, then they come in and they're sort of the last trade to go through the house.
It doesn't hold the process up whatsoever. It's a very easy, simple process, you know. Couple days and they're in and out and they're gone, so you know, and it works pretty good.
Now, in a large home, an entire sprinkler system can be installed in about a day or two. Municipal officials often have the authority to offer valuable trade-up options for sprinkler developments.
Some of the things that we can do is give you credits for fire flow, for fire hydrant placement. We can be creative with our access requirements, and sometimes we can even help you get an increased density for the development you want to do.
Now, trade-ups might include street width reduction, longer dead-end streets, use of T-turnarounds, increased grades and building setbacks, increased hydrant spacing, and additional units. Some communities may also offer a reduction in fire-rated separation requirements. Residential sprinkler costs can now be substantially reduced and offset. Homeowners have never been more concerned about home safety than they are now. Builders and developers are realizing that home fire sprinklers are not only good for the community, they're good for business as well.
I think it's great. When we first started it, we promoted it as safety features in the homes, and people accepted it, and it helped spark sales. You know, people felt good about going into a house that was fully sprinkled.
I became convinced that fire sprinklers was the only way to go. It was one extra that you had to pass along to a homeowner where they actually receive something back. And by that I mean, if you have a fire sprinkler in your home, not only do you have the peace of mind of the safety factor for your family and the minimized damage in case of a fire, you also get money back, depending on your insurance company, and savings on your homeowner's insurance.
It gives me a good feeling when I go to bed at night. I know that the homes that I built since 1990 are protected by a sprinkler system.
Communities know the simple truth. Home fire sprinklers save property and lives.
I'm tickled to death that this community was so proactive in the sprinkler system. And we have really evolved into a community that people now want to come to.
When a home is built with fire sprinkler protection, that home will be protected for the life of the home, regardless of how many times the occupants change.
The data is right there in front of us. What we need to do is make that data real to the rest of the public so they understand that sprinklers are not a cost, it's an investment for safety.
I think consumers who are very, very safety conscious are asking about them. They want them, and I think residential sprinklers is an idea whose time has very definitely come.
The Home Fire Sprinkler Coalition is here to help if you need it. Please visit our website at homefiresprinkler.org. Thanks for watching.